Hello everyone, and welcome back to today's analysis. Now for the 30th episode, I'm going to analyze none other than Darth Sidious, the main antagonist of the Star Wars franchise. By far the most diabolical villain ever created, this episode is a special episode to me, because just like how Dr. Manhattan is my favorite cinematic hero, Palpatine from Star Wars is my favorite cinematic villain, as the amount of pure evil, intelligence, charisma, symbolism, and even realism behind his character, and the way he went to foresaw all this evil and went to fulfill his plans is truly both genius and terrifying at the same time. And maybe I am bold with my statements, it's simply my belief that Palpatine is the greatest villain to ever appear in cinema, as coupled with the fact that he is often praised as the most diabolical fictional character ever created. In this episode, I'm going to analyze all the information given about Palpatine throughout all the movies and the TV shows of the franchise to better understand Darth Sidious in his journey from a simple, self-serving youth that he has once been to the tyrannical mastermind and galactic overlord he has ultimately become. Now, without further ado, let's begin. Sheev Palpatine was born on Naboo in 84 BBY to his father, Consigna Palpatine, and an unknown mother. After him, he also had two triplet siblings, two brothers and two sisters. And throughout his life, while growing up, Palpatine was considered an outcast not just by the Naboo society, but even by his own family, as his father was a corrupt and violent politician, and both his mother and siblings were all subservient to their father. Of course, Palpatine didn't want to have anything to do with him, given the fact that Sheev didn't want to be another puppet of his father's evil schemes, and because of this, his father and the rest of the family treated Palpatine like he's some sort of an outcast. Not to mention that he often got in problems with the law, as he was often expelled from many prestigious schools on Naboo, and even from the entire galaxy at large. And it's even implied that he got into an accident into a pedestrian race that killed two people. Of course, his father had to bribe the police, so his son wouldn't end up in jail. Eventually, this only strained the relationship already pretty fragile between him and his father, and as well as making him to seem like a murderer in the eyes of his own family and the public. But of course, one day he met the one person that will change him forever, the one person that gave him a path to everything he wanted and more, his eventual Sith master and predecessor, Darth Plagueis the Wise, known to the rest of the galaxy as Senator Higo Damask II, of the intergalactic banking clan, who sensed immense potential in Palpatine and officially wanted to test the boy. And after he and his father confronted with each other on a starship, Palpatine ended up killing his entire family and all the guards and the pilots that were aboard. And with this single act, Palpatine finally baptized himself into the dark side of the Force and officially joined Darth Plagueis and the Sith Order, becoming known as Darth Sidious, the Sith apprentice of Plagueis, and he's spending the rest of his life helping him and the Sith at large to fulfill the grand plan of the Sith. The grand plan that was founded 1000 years prior by Darth Bane, the one who created the Rule of Two, in which claims that only two Sith can exist at any given time, a master to embody the power of the dark side, and an apprentice to crave that power. And throughout his apprenticeship, he discovered that Plagueis was actually obsessed in finding immortality, as he managed to find two ways to achieve such a thing. First of all, is through manipulating the midichlorians in order to resurrect others from death, and even to use them to create life. Unfortunately, that method ultimately expired, as he discovered that the Force itself could actually counterattack such a technique. The other technique, more simple and more sure to success, is transferring one's consciousness into another one's body and using that body as a vessel, something that Palpatine will later come to use in life. And upon becoming Senator of Naboo and learning everything he needed from Plagueis, Sidious killed his own master in his sleep and took his position as the new Dark Lord of the Sith, and he took his first apprentice into the Young Maul, against young Datomirian Zabrak, who officially kidnapped from his mother, Mother Talzin, training him as Darth Maul and trained him for years, as well as mercilessly torturing and abusing him in order to make him into a living weapon, as well as creating connections with other various factions throughout the galaxy, such as the Trade Federation, the Geonosis Hive, the Intergalactic Banking Clan, the Corporate Alliance, the Techno Union, and even into the infamous Count Dooku, the Count of Cirino, and former Jedi Master, who left the Order through the fact that he lost his faith in it. And finally, by 32 BBI, the first step in his plans to control the galaxy was officially achieved, as he had a trade federation to invade his own planet of Naboo, in order for him to gain enough sympathy in the Galactic Senate, in order to win the elections as Supreme Chancellor, given the Fedefinis Valorum has officially fulfilled already 2 terms as Chancellor, and with Palpatine ultimately succeeding in doing so, and ascended to position as Supreme Chancellor of the Republic. However, the Trade Federation losing on Naboo and the presumed death of his first apprentice ultimately caused Sidious to look for a new Sith apprentice, which he found in Count Dooku, who ultimately managed to turn him to the dark side of the Force and made him into Darth Tyrannus, his second Sith apprentice, who will have him to take control of various factions across the galaxy and influence the galactic stage in order to further solidify his plan, which culminated in 24 BBI, with Dooku establishing the Confederacy of Independent Systems, with himself as head of state, but with Sidious himself as de facto leader. And because of this, Palpatine was granted emergency powers by the Galactic Senate, allowing him to create a Republic military and officially gain more powers than a normal Chancellor would have, as well as eliminating term limits and elections, and allowing him to remain in power as long as the crisis is abated. But throughout his time in the Republic, he gained an immense interest into one specific person, Anakin Skywalker, a young boy that Qui Gon Jinn had saved from Tatooine during the invasion of Naboo, and who officially became the Padawan of Obi-Wan Kenobi. And furthermore, it's even implied that Anakin is the prophesied chosen one, meant to destroy the Sith. And because of this, Sidious took an immense interest in Anakin, as he often spent a lot of time with him, and even made sure that he became a father figure to him, all in the purpose to manipulate him so he can one day become his new Sith apprentice. And ultimately, by 22 BBI, the Clone Wars, a galactic-level war, has officially started between the Republic and the Separatists, with himself as the leader of both factions, controlling the Republic as Chancellor Palpatine, and controlling the Separatists as Darth Sidious, and thus, Palpatine put himself into a position in which no matter the outcome, he will emerge as the ultimate victor. Now, I could go in detail for each atrocity committed by the Separatists, and each battle they casted countless lives and murdered numerous innocents, but ultimately, Sidious is completely responsible for all of this, as the Clone Wars costed billions of deaths across the entire galaxy, not to mention the various experimentation was made in order to further the Separatists' own ends. As throughout the prequel trilogy, Palpatine represents the fear of democracy being subverted and turning to tyranny, much like how other historical dictators such as Julius Caesar, who corrupted the Roman Republic and allowed Augustus to turn into an empire years later, Napoleon Bonaparte, who corrupted the First French Republic in order to create his French Empire, and Adolf Hitler, who corrupted the Weimar Republic and turned into the Nazi Germany. Not to mention that the former president Richard Nixon, who tried to abolish the 22nd Amendment in the US Constitution in order to allow himself to become president for life. Thankfully, Nixon has failed, but tragically Palpatine succeeded in Star Wars, as he gained more and more power as the war continued, allowing himself to become a dictator in all but name. And finally, by 19 BBI, the last step of his plan to take over the galaxy ultimately solidified, as he orchestrated his own kidnapping, resulting in both Anakin Skywalker and Obi-Wan Kenobi coming to save him. And finally, Anakin managed to murder Tyrannus after his role was completely finished, as well as having Kenobi and the other clone troopers in order to hunt down and kill the other Separatist leaders. And ultimately, all of this was made in the purpose to lure Anakin closer and closer to the dark side of the Force, as he used in the tragedy of his mother's death, the abandonment of his own Padawan, and ultimately the fear of his own wife, Padme Amidala, who ultimately passed away due to childbirth. Sidious used all of this in order to lure Anakin to the dark side, with a false promise that he knows how to save his wife from the lessons that he learned from Darth Plagueis. And following the discovery of his true nature by the Jedi, and the failed arrest that eventually was about to become an execution, Anakin betrayed the Jedi, and finally joined the dark side of the Force, becoming Darth Vader, the third Sith apprentice of Darth Sidious, and through him, Sidious will officially order the eradication of all the Jedi in the temple, as well as giving the Order 66 to the other clone troopers through the inhibitor chips put in them in order to destroy every single Jedi across the galaxy. And finally, with the Separatists and the Jedi gunning out of his way, Palpatine finally took complete control over the Republic and the Senate, and officially reorganized everything into the first Galactic Empire, with himself as his Galactic Emperor, finally succeeding his goal to take over the galaxy and restoring back the Sith Empire. However, as the eventual duel with Yoda, and his eventual subsequent escape left Twin Sidious with immense fear that one day the Jedi could officially return, which he ultimately did. And finally, Vader being defeated and injured severely on Mustafar by Obi-Wan Kenobi, and put him into an artificial suit in order to support him for the rest of his life. And throughout his reign, Sidious ordered the imperialization of the galaxy. The Galactic Senate became the Imperial Senate. The Grand Army of the Republic became the Imperial Armada. The clone troopers were getting rid of and replaced by Imperial Stormtroopers. And various ships once belonging to the Republic have ultimately been imperialized and changed. And the Grand Jedi Temple on Coruscant was reorganized into an Imperial Palace, you know, as a seat of his power and as the ultimate victory that he had against the Jedi. As well as having many various figures in the Empire, such as Grand Moff Tarkin and Darth Vader, to impose orders by crushing any rebel insurgency, and officially having the Inquisitors to hunt down and exterminate every single Jedi who survived Order 66, as well as creating super weapons such as the Death Star in order to impose his order throughout the galaxy through fear and oppression, ultimately leading to the creation of the Alliance to restore the Republic, or the Rebel Alliance into BDI, which ultimately kickstarted the Galactic Civil War, which led to the destruction of the Death Star in Zero BBI and the Battle of Yavin. But even without this, the Empire didn't collapse so easily, but only began to fracture across the galaxy. As with the Death Star, various high-ranking Imperial figures such as Tarkin were ultimately killed, resulting in immense crackdown of all the rebels across the galaxy. And now by 3 ABI, Sidious finally realized that the rebel pilot who destroyed the first Death Star was in fact Luke Skywalker, the last Jedi, and the son of Anakin Skywalker. And while revealing this to Vader, which is in fact Luke's father, in order to kill him, Vader managed to change his mind by making him to believe that Luke can become a powerful ally by being turned to the dark side. Sidious agreed with this, given the fact that he in reality wanted to make Luke his new Sith apprentice, and to replace Vader, who was considered a broken master. Now, throughout the original trilogy, Sidious is obviously portrayed as the archetype of the evil emperor, as numerous emperors across histories, and especially the Roman emperors, were also confirmed to be partial inspiration for Sidious. But now, before I go any further, we all should stop and ask ourselves, is Palpatine evil? The reason why I'm asking is simply because, while it's undeniably that he is pure evil, George Lucas stated in the novelization of Episode 3 that Palpatine is a well-intentioned extremist and the hero of his own story. However, Sidious's actions far surpass the concept of being a well-intentioned extremist, as coupled with the fact that he ordered the genocide of an entire order and complete genocide over numerous species, as well as oppressing an entire galaxy full of trillions, you know, quadrillions of people that he ruined throughout his reign, ultimately makes this well-intentioned extremism completely unjustified. Not to mention that there is no proof in the movies or even the TV shows that this is the case. Another thing that could be discussed here is actually his backstory. Coupled with the fact that he was hated by his own family might have been a result of what's happened to him. Given the fact that from his backstory, anyone can understand two things. One, Palpatine was quite misunderstood by the rest of his peers. But two, you can also understand it in a way he was kind of born evil, in the sense that he was always the same evil, selfish and corrupt person that he always was. He's not. As even before Darth Plagueis found him, Palpatine was already evil and corrupt to the core. Now, another thing that should be analyzed here is the fact that the possibility that Palpatine might suffer from antisocial personality disorder. As just like Anakin suffers from borderline personality disorder, this disorder causes one to be incapable to feel love or empathy towards anyone around them. And in thus, in another way, it could be argued that Sidious might be mentally ill, as coupled with the fact that he is unable to feel love or to be selfless to others, given the fact that these concepts are alien to him, ultimately proves that Palpatine might genuinely is incapable to feel anything but to be evil. However, even if this is the case, he seems to be morally aware of the consequences of his actions, not to mention that he even is aware that he is the bad guy of the story, and he genuinely enjoys being one. He is a murderer, he is a monster, and he is even capable to end his own bloodline for his own benefit. Not to mention that he did not become the Emperor for the good of the galaxy. He is not someone who is misunderstood and wants to be make himself hurt. He is not someone who has betrayed and wants revenge. He is not even hateful towards the galaxy like Vader. No, Palpatine is worse. Darth Sidious is the absolute worst. He doesn't care at all about anyone, but only and only about himself. And at the end of the day, the answer to the question, is Darth Sidious evil, is the big and clear yes. Palpatine is the official embodiment of pure evil, in my opinion. And now by 4ABI, as the Galactic Civil War is drawing to a close, Sidious came with his latest plan to bring about the Empire's victory by creating a new Death Star above Endor and using Sela as a bait to lure the Rebel fleet in order to destroy them, as well as attempting to persuade Luke to finally kill Vader, his own father, and to take his place as his new Sith apprentice. But ultimately Luke refused to do so, claiming that he is a Jedi like his father before him, and Sidious trying to kill him before sliding for failing to do so, to corrupt Luke, ultimately resulting in Vader redeeming himself, and finally killed Palpatine by throwing him to the second Death Star's core reactor, officially destroying the Sith Order, and fulfilled the prophecy of the Chosen One, which led to Anakin ultimately dying into the hands of his son, and finally redeeming himself. And ultimately, after the battle, the second Death Star was officially destroyed, and the Galactic Empire began to collapse, and the Rebel Alliance officially reorganized itself into the New Republic. However, even that was not the end for Darth Sidious, as he, unlike many other villains, was actually smart enough to see the possibility of his own death, and he put in place a plan, the contingency that would see the destruction of his old empire and its remnants escape into the unknown regions so can they start over, which culminated in 5ABI, with the Galactic Civil War being over, the Empire collapsed, the New Republic victorious, which became the new government of the galaxy, and the Imperial remnants have escaped to the great unknown, when they officially regrouped and reorganized themselves. And while Palpatine all along managed to resurrect himself on Exegol, which he managed to create for himself a clone body, over which his consciousness managed to escape to upon the death of his original body. However, because the clone body couldn't support the immense spirit of Sidious, ultimately caused rapid deterioration, as well as the fact that he became blind and immobile, and he needed a mechanical device in order to move around. But nevertheless, Palpatine didn't stop at this, as he managed to create two more clones that all proved to be useful to him. The first being Snoke, a disfigured humanoid alien with immense force sensitivity that will become a puppet leader in his new plans. And Dayton, a normal and healthy human with no connection to the Force whatsoever, was tasked by Sidious in order to continue the bloodline so he can create a healthy Force-sensitive descendant, as well as the creation of the Final Order, a fleet of starships capable to destroy a planet, having each one the capabilities of both the Death Stars and the Starkiller base, the ultimate weapon of the First Order, as this fleet will make it more easier to control than the aforementioned super weapons, so Palpatine can use them to retake back the galaxy. And by 15ABI, two major things officially happened. First was the restoration of the Jedi Order by Luke Skywalker, as he began to train a new generation of Jedi on Otus. The second thing was the birth of his granddaughter, Rey, as Dayton and Miramir officially fall in love and marry together, and officially decide to live on Jakku as nobodies in order to protect their daughter from her evil grandfather. And because of this, Sidious ordered his assassin, Ochiel Veston, to track down and bring Rey to him. As well as the fact that Luke Skywalker sensed the dark side is rising again from the unknown regions, and started his own journey to find Exegol. All of this leading to 21ABI, in which Rey was finally abandoned by her parents on Jakku, while her parents were ultimately killed by Ochi at the orders of Palpatine, finally killing his own son and his own daughter-in-law as revenge for hiding his granddaughter from him, as well as the creation of the First Order, a new Imperialist military junta dedicated to destroy the New Republic and the Jedi and restore back the Galactic Empire, with Snoke acting as his supreme leader, but with Palpatine himself becoming the de facto leader. And finally, Luke Skywalker given up on his search to find Exegol after he couldn't find anything. And with now all of this in place, Sidious began to manipulate the one person they wanted as his new apprentice, Ben Solo, the son of Leia Skywalker and Han Solo, and the nephew and the padawan of Luke Skywalker, as he saw in him the exact same potential as he felt in Anakin many decades prior, which all of this led to the year 28ABI, in which upon the revelation to the Galactic Senate that both Luke and Leia are the children of Darth Vader, ultimately resulted in their reputations, as well as Leia's political career, to be ruined, and Ben's trust in his family was ultimately shattered. And after Luke's failed attempted murder of his own nephew while he slept, ultimately resulted in Ben Solo turning to the dark side of the Force and destroy the new generation of Jedi, leading to him to become Kylo Ren, Master of the Knights of Ren, and Warlord into the First Order, as well as the apprentice of Supreme Leader Snoke and the de facto apprentice of Darth Sidious, Luke Skywalker went into exile, searching for the first Jedi Temple as a response to his nephew's fall to the dark, into darkness, and Leia created the Resistance, a paramilitary organization dedicated to protect the New Republic from the First Order. And from 29 ABI, officially a Cold War has started between the First Order and the New Republic, which culminated in 34 ABI with the destruction of the Hosnian system at the hands of the Starkiller base, the First Order's ultimate weapon. They ultimately collapsed the New Republic and started a new galactic war against the Resistance. Just like with the Separatists and the Empire, Palpatine is also completely responsible for each and every single atrocity committed by the First Order, as each life, each broken world, and each destroyed planet are all traced back to Darth Sidious, as he is responsible for the deaths of billions, if not even trillions of innocents. But of course, at the same time, a new force has risen in the galaxy, Rey, his own granddaughter, who discovered her force sensitivity and helped the Resistance to destroy the Starkiller base, as well as finding Luke Skywalker and training herself into the ways of a Jedi. Not to mention the death of Supreme Leader Snoke at the hands of Kylo Ren, his subsequent ascension as the new Supreme Leader, and ultimately the death of Luke Skywalker. Palpatine managed to basically avenge his first death at 30 years after it. And finally, by 35 ABI, after he was presumed dead by the galaxy for over 30 years, he finally revealed himself through a galactic-level broadcast, in which he declared that he is still alive and his plans for revenge, resulting into some sort of a race between the Resistance and the First Order in finding and killing Palpatine, resulting in Kylo Ren ultimately tracking him down to Exegol, but instead to kill him, Sidious offered him an offer. There were promises of the future of as a leader of a new and improved empire in exchange for him to kill Rey, the last Jedi, and his own granddaughter, as well as having Kylo Ren to reveal the truth about her origins to her. A fake attempt by Ren to convince Rey to turn to the dark side so they both can kill Sidious and take over the Sith Eternal and the Final Order. Sidious, of course, was aware of all of this and even counted on it, as ultimately following Ben Solo's redemption, and he made the General Pride the new de facto Supreme Leader of the First Order, as well as ultimately baiting Rey to the planet, and to lure the Resistance in order to destroy them, using the Final Order's might. Throughout the sequel trilogy, Sidious is portrayed as the fear of the evil that was once defeated to be destroyed once more, and this one makes a lot of sense, given the fact that even today, various dictators such as Vladimir Putin in Russia and Xi Jinping in China, as well as Kim Jong-un in North Korea, and Ali Khamenei in Iran, and even the former President Donald Trump, all of them are completely horrible and corrupt politicians that even attempt to create a new fascist world order throughout our world. And as Rey has come, he ultimately revealed his plan to her, that he intends for her to kill him so he can transfer his spirit into her and use her body as a vessel in order to rule over a new empire. Thankfully, Rey has ultimately declined to do so, as well as the arrival of a redeemed Ben Solo that culminated into the deaths of the Knights of Ren, but Sidious using the Force managed to absorb the life force out of both of them in order to fully rejuvenate himself and decide to take over the throne for himself once more, as he wanted to finally rule the galaxy again as Emperor, as well as casting Ben Solo into the pit as revenge for his first death at the hands of Anakin Skywalker, as in all in the purpose to end the Skywalker bloodline once and for all, and he himself tried to destroy the Resistance by launching his Force Lightning at them, intends to kill all of them, and finally rule once again as over the entire galaxy through a new Sith Empire. Thankfully, Rey managed to regain all her strength, and with the help of all the Jedi before her, she finally managed to kill Darth Sidious once and for all, as finally killing her own grandfather and ending his evil goals for galactic domination once and for all. And through this, the Sith Eternal has been destroyed throughout the blast, and the Final Order ultimately collapsed, resulting in the death of Supreme Leader Pride and the eventual collapse of the First Order, ending the war with a Resistance victory, but all at the cost of Rey's life, as Ben finally managed to come back and sacrifice his own life force to resurrect Rey and vanish into the Force as a result, officially ending the Skywalker bloodline. So, and nevertheless, at the end, Palpatine could be argued to have won, given the fact that he ultimately succeeded in one goal, to end the Skywalker family. But nevertheless, Rey changed her last name into Skywalker in order to repudiate her Palpatine legacy and officially started her own journey to restore the Jedi Order, finally showing that finally leaving all her grandfather's evil goals in complete vain. So in the end, who was Darth Sidious? He was nothing more but an evil megalomaniac that desired more power and prestige in his own name. A man, a monster in fact, that would sacrifice anyone and anything in order to achieve his ultimate power. A monster that would overthrow a thousand-year democracy and install a fascist dictatorship with himself as the absolute ruler. A dictatorship that would ultimately collapse and he would attempt to do the same thing all over again. A monster that could easily be called as one of the most iconic, most diabolical and most unredeemable villain that ever appeared in cinematic history. Thank you all for tuning this new episode in today's analysis. I hope you all guys enjoyed. Please don't forget to give a like and subscribe to my channel. And may the Force serve you well.
Once more, the Sith will rule the galaxy.
And we shall...